Hello friends, this is Andrea, the Plumeria gal, here in Brooklyn in this cold day. It's out, I think they said it's 19 degrees outside, but it sure feels like zero, very cold. And we got beautiful bright sunlight, beautiful day, it looks so deceiving, it's not funny. What you see before me is, I'm going to make dinner. I wanted to do something different, videotape this, because I really want to know how I accomplished this. First time that I'm making oxtails. Actually, I've made it before. Maybe about 15, maybe about 20 years ago. And I totally forgot. If you don't do something often, you quite lose the handle of things. So I'm gonna mimic and see how this goes. If you hear noise in the background, forgive me. That's my nephew. And he's with my daughter. I'm supposed to be babysitting. I want to start dinner because this takes about 4 hours to make. And actually, I got this ingredient actually online. I think it's from Food Network and it's Neely's oxtail. Because I got the ingredients from her. So I never saw the show program, but I heard it comes on a Food Network. Just want to copy it and kind of like improvise and add my own little thing to it. So this is a collection of items. I have beef broth here. I have cherry, the cherry flavor of our Minestrone. I'm gonna stew the oxtails in it along with the broth. And I have some contadina tomatoes. The paste as well, and Parmesan. I'm gonna do something delicate. And she suggested that we have noodles along with the oxtail, which is totally different because normally oxtails when we eat in the Caribbean, they like to have it with rice, white rice. So we're gonna use noodles this time and see how that is. And here's the oxtails. I'm gonna have them right now soaked in some kosher salt. And it's been in there for about 20 minutes. It usually softens it, so, and it's in cold water. I'm gonna, shortly after this video, I'm going to rinse it off really well and sprinkle some pepper on it. I don't have the pepper here. I forgot the pepper. And coat it with flour. I have like a half a cup of flour here. So I'm gonna get started. My hands obviously has to be free to do all these things. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll bring you along the progress of this. Okay, I'll bring you along the progress. So let me get moving, and you guys see me in a short few minutes. Okay, bye. Okay, friends, what I decided to do was improvise a bit. I decided to sprinkle some Mrs. Dash on the oxtails before I coat it with flour. So, forgive me, my nephew in the living room. You may hear strange sounds in the background, TV. I decided to sprinkle the sour dash, Mrs. Dash, on the oxtail. And if you look over here in my Dutch pot, I have these guys now. A few at a time. I'm browning them on all sides. I started at one side. This takes about 10 minutes on each side. Maybe less. You have to keep an eye on it, that it doesn't burn, and make sure it doesn't burn. And rotate it. So when I'm done with that, with this batch here, I'll put it in a plate and hold it aside until all the meat has been browned, and I will compile the other ingredients to make the broth, which will include the goodies on the table here, everything that you see here, almost everything. The Parmesan is for the noodles, and everything else is for the broth that I'll make it to simmer down the meat. So it's a 4 hour process, 4 to 5 hours sometimes, depending on the thickness of the meat. And as you can see here, this is pretty thick. So that's going to take me probably, I have a few pieces like that. have a few pieces like that. Very, very thick and meaty. Sorry for the distortion. Nice, fresh, healthy cuts of oxtail. Now I gotta wash my hands. And it's gonna take probably 5 hours, roughly. Yeah, give or take. So, I'll bring you along for the journey and let you see what the output looked like, okay? Talk to you soon. Bye. Here we go, guys. I just finished browning this. Took me more than boot to YouTube. Took me more than an hour, actually, to brown all of this. This is like 6 pounds of oxtails. You want to get taped? Silly guy. Shh, I'm taping. Okay. What I had to do is saute the mix here. I'm going to add my tomatoes and the paste. And looking good. It needs another 5 minutes so the onions can brown. And then I'll dump it in. Let me close it. And my paste is over here. And I'm going to get it together. That's my nephew. Forgive me. He wants to be here and make me crazy. You got your pajamas on. I'm not going to put you on the film. Anyway, see you guys soon. Bye. Alrighty, that's the tomato paste in there. Here is the half a bottle. I think I'm gonna put a little bit more cherry wine in here. Yeah, baby. Woohoo! You see that? Alright. My daughter looking at me like I lost it. Let's put another, like a half a cup there. I suppose. Oh, shucks. It's a little bit more than this. Yep. A quarter. I feel like about 6 pounds of oxtail. So I don't have a tripod, so forgive me. But here's oxtails again. And soon, once this gets bubbly, I'm going to stir it right now. Everything from the bottom of the pot. Stirring it. And so the paste. I also gotta add in the beef broth as well as tomato sauce. So what you saw before was the paste. Now I gotta add in the tomato sauce as well as the beef broth. So you'll see everything when it's done and finished. That'll be another 3 hours from now. Hi friend, this is Andrea again, sorry for shaking the camera. I'm going to stir the oxtails, and do you see how delicious that looks scrumptious. This is going to take another hour and a half to really fall off the bones, to let the juices melt within the meat. Everything is there, so I just occasionally stir it every 20 minutes or so. It's the carrots and the tomatoes and the celery, onions and garlic, thyme, all the fine herbs. You can imagine it's in there. Yeah, I come back here in another 20 minutes or so to stir this. I'm going to leave it now. That's what it looks like now. I'm going to leave that and just cover it up and go for the white rice. In here it is. I got I think this is 2 cups of rice in here. Yeah, I made 2 cups of rice. So it's not a big, big pot, but it's enough for all of us here. And sorry, forgive me. I only got one hand to use. And I'm trying to dry it out. I think I put a little bit too much water. I usually use olive oil in my water, but I didn't have any. I ran out, actually. I had to use most of it for the oxtail. So I kind of came out mushy using butter. I hate using butter. But I did it. Big mistake. It's better to use olive oil. Then you wouldn't have this potato-ish like rice. That's what I find. I don't know. Some people know how to put enough more butter in their rice, but I don't like using butter, and that's the reason why, because the rice becomes clumpy like that. I like using olive oil or, you know, vegetable oil. Yeah, anyhow. So, guys, When everything is finished and done, I will put the plate together and you will see this girl chomp down. Oh yeah. Then the rice is done. I'm just gonna, actually let me leave this open and turn this off. Okay. And we were gonna make the noodles. I was gonna make the noodles. I wanted noodles. But everybody said no, they don't want noodles. You know, just leave the right rice. So I said, okay, fine. So I'm gonna put all this away. And we'll have the rest of our wine with it. A glass of wine for the Sabbath. And that's it. And this is like I told you, I got this from the Food Network. I like how it looked. And I want to try it. And that's Gina's Oxtail Stew. You can find it in Food Network channel. Comes with the ingredients here. There's a long list of things to get. But I substituted for some of the ingredients, like it required mushrooms. I'm allergic to mushrooms. I can't have mushrooms. I didn't add dry red wine. I added my own wine. And, you know, with oxtails, you could improvise and you'll be all right. You know, oxtails, you can't really mess up oxtails. I just want you to know that. Okay, so when the plate is finished, I will bring you guys back up and you can see it. All right, see you soon. Bye. Oh, sorry guys, I decided to launch into this plate without even, I totally forgot that I was talking to you guys and letting you know how this meal is gonna look. Got my little manischewitz there. And my plate filled with oxtail and white rice. I'm just digging in. And I have my dessert. A donut, chocolate donut. Hey. Oh, you guys should taste this. Really tastes good. See ya. That's dinner for tonight for the family. Bye. Hello, friends. This morning it's this afternoon. I'm going to make my minestrone. Today, here in New York, Brooklyn, we are like, what we have, 14 degrees? 15? My nephew is here. About 11 degrees?
Yeah, it's snowing out there.
It just started snowing?
It started snowing at like 2:30.
My goodness. This is crazy, guys. I don't know. New York City, we have been under siege with frozen temperatures. Oh, I'm sorry. I shouldn't be zooming in. My daughter just walked in from work and she just told me it's 11 degrees. I can't believe it. So that means it's negative, it's below zero with the wind chills.
No, not really.
It's not windy yet? This storm's supposed to start on Tuesday. It's really crazy. Well, but I gathered here. I'm making minestrone, okay? I have my Swiss chard, my nephew's Swiss chard. I have about a pound here. I have my beef stock, Parmesan, I have the potatoes, the celery that you see, the pancetta is in the delicatessen package right there. And my herbs, my tomatoes, and my olive oil, and rosemary, and carrots. I think I have everything to start this soup. So I'm going to make this. I'm going to allow you guys to walk with me, okay? So I'm going to put this together and prepare it, because I don't have a tripod to put the camera on a stand. But I'll start preparing it, putting it in the pot, and then you should see the results, okay? Wish me luck. See you soon. Bye. Hey, friends. This is Andrea again. My minestrone is finito. All done. Nice and thick. Oh my. I'm getting a lot of steam here. Sorry. But everything is all melted down. The cheese, the beans, and the Swiss chard, and the tomatoes, and the carrots, and what have you. All melted down there. And I'm about to split. Oh, 1 second. Got a lot of steam. Sorry about that. I had to move the camera. I'm going to pour some in the bowl. Give me a second. Okie dokie. I just poured some in the bowl here. It's all nice and done. Finished. Lovely. Took me an hour. It always going to take me an hour to make soups. More than an hour for this, actually. Because I had to chop up a lot of little tiny carrots and the onions and the Swiss chard and the, you know, different things. I use fresh herbs, as you saw earlier. So I'm going to enjoy and dig into this. And I have some Italian bread here. Not that I need it, but I like to have something more than just this luscious vegetarian dinner. So that's it. It's done. Complete. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye. Yum, yum, yum. This is really, really, it tastes so good. Oh my goodness, it tastes so good. This is yummy. And my grandmother made it. Can't remember if she had some of these things in it. I remember the Swiss chard. That was like spinach, so that I remembered. The celery, carrots, I remembered. The tomatoes, fresh tomatoes, and the beans, I remembered. But like, adding the pancetta. I know she added something else, a different type of meat. I don't know if it's pancetta. I doubt it. My grandmother always cooked with bones and things like that. It stewed the beans, and she made a lot of rice and used different types of beans. And pretty much we were raised with Spanish, Latin, Caribbean foods. So if she was alive today, she'd be well over 100. And I'm just going back into trying to cook the way she used to cook. And finding ideas online. Thank God for Food Network. That pulled things together for me. Otherwise, forget it. I would be out of the boxes. Box foods. Box dinners. Box lunch. But, yeah. So, I enjoy cooking. That's another passion of mine, is cooking, planting, painting, playing music, listening to music. God bless. Salud. And reading books. That's pretty much how I am. I spend most of my time reading and writing. Playing around my instruments. Flute. I try to learn how to play guitar on my own. Play the piano. So, you get to know this young lady here. Yep. I'm young. According to my adult kids, they think I'm old, but I am still young. So, I'm going to enjoy this minestrone, guys. I hope you enjoy it too. All right. Thanks for watching. And if you like the video, please let me know. Give me a thumbs up. If you don't like it, you don't have to say anything. No problem. Anyway, God bless. Love you all. Bye-bye.